Preparing for the zombie apocalypse?
Yeah, storage.
So that, like, you know, when...
Long-term storage unit kind of thing.
So if we were attacked by zombies, how long do you think you'd survive?
3.5 minutes.
3.5 minutes? How do you think you'd go down?
I don't know. How do you think I'd go down?
I would think swinging, but I'm not sure.
Well,
I thought so until you said it would last for three minutes.
I don't have any guns.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I could lock the door here and starve myself out. Yeah, I don't think I'd last long.
Yeah, I don't think I'd last long either.
Yeah.
Although, I would probably try.
Well, I think I'd like to become a zombie.
Yeah? Well, you think you'd be like the front guard of zombies?
Well, yeah, I mean, at least you're doing something, you know, running around eating people, sucking their brains out and stuff.
it's like better than jazzercise, being a zombie.
It's like the 6-minute abs.
Yeah, there are very few really big zombies, at least on television and the movies.
So I was thinking a good diet plan would be to bottle water from India and sell it here. Sasquatch Music Festival is been a tradition for quite a while now. The first one was a one-day festival started by Adam Zaks, and his idea was to have a music festival out at the Gorge with multiple bands and stuff like that. And they sold out that first year, and then it became a multi-day festival, and so that's kind of what it is now. And Sasquatch Music Festival is basically a festival that you know, gets dozens of really good bands, and that's kind of what their strong point has been throughout the years. Their music selection is a pretty big variety, so it draws people from different demographics and age groups, and it's kind of a big collage of people with different music interests going to the same festival. And yeah, it's one of those festivals that usually sells out, and which at the Gorge is a pretty big deal. There's, you know, tens of thousands of people that are in attendance, and basically there to have fun, have a good time, enjoy themselves, watch a lot of good music, and, you know, have some sort of weekend experience that's above and beyond, you know, a normal weekend. You know, I just happen to have a lot of connections with a lot of good artists, and a lot of street artists, and a lot of street and gallery artists, and where that kind of like combination comes together. And I basically chose the artists I chose because they are artists that know how to work in diverse environments. I chose a lot of street artists basically because they have the ability to install art in an environment and get response from their installations.
Well, I have a really simple design, but I think it's pretty effective. This is called cellophane graffiti, if you will. And that's merely saran wrap stretched between two points and spray painted on with stencils and freehand. I was a little concerned earlier about the wind, but I think I chose a good spot, so I'm pretty protected. Well, you know, the interesting thing about this art is that it is ephemeral. In fact, when I was setting up, a drunk girl fell through this. It was a little unfortunate. She was really apologetic, but she helped me set it back up again, so it was a happy ending.
Oh, Korea, Pata Korea.
pata ko se makata yu. Yeah, it's nice to be able to hear myself again.
Quickly or slowly, it needs to be done, and what actually goes into each different artist's piece. Like, we all have different techniques and different methods, and it's cool to see it all come together. All, like, the different styles. It's a lot of fun.
So basically, I chose artists that have had the ability, that I felt had the ability to communicate really well with their audience, and I wanted artists that were interactive and knew how to describe their process of what they're doing with people, and include people in what they're doing and how they're doing it, so they can, you know, inspire, make those connections, and make the people at the festival feel really connected with the performance element.
Well, I wanted to bring love to Sasquatch, and I also it was built on a series that I've been working on with the Seattle Art Museum. I did two big paintings for some of the live painting events that we had with them, and I wanted to continue it in that vein. So I took these spider creatures and sort of like these alien spider creatures, and I made the third one in the series. And the first two, one was abstract, the other one was more pop, and then the third one was very much about love and had little hearts and things on it. And I just felt like Sasquatch was a good place to share love, and a good place for that sensibility. My first really absolutely jaw-dropping moment was walking up to the narwhal stage, and Ryan and I both had murals on top of that stage. They might actually still be there, I'm not sure. I was just walking, and then all of a sudden seeing both of our murals on the other each side of the stage was just absolutely amazing. And it just, like, I had a permagrin for days after that. It was almost too much. It was just too amazing and too happy making and too exciting. And then the second one was when I finally saw Ryan's mural completed. I was dumbfounded that he was able to create that in the space of, what was it, 3 days or was it 2 days? It was 2 days. And that was just absolutely just bonkers to me. I think that if I had tried to do that, it would have killed me. It was just, I was in awe. And I think a lot of people were too. I know that that Ryan's brother was just absolutely proud of his brother. It was just absolutely amazing.
A lot of times, you know, in a music festival, there's this kind of disconnect from performers and the audience, and, you know, I felt like my job as a curator was to find a group of people that knew how to connect with people, knew how to do installation work, knew how to do something original, and, you know, I brought myself plus 13 other artists, and each one of those artists brought a project in a different way. And so, you know, we had these 14, basically 14 art stations set up around the festival where any of the festival attendees could have a conversation with, feel included and part of the creative performance aspect of the festival. And, you know, my artists that I chose did an excellent job in pulling that off. They were just, you know, each one of them I saw just lit up with joy and excitement the whole time about, you know, not just having a stage to, and a place to show their artwork for it to be viewed, but to really make relationships, really make connections, and you know, bridge those gaps and make, you know, kind of get our goal across of make it more of an actual festival where it's based in participation and based in getting to know people and relationships and, you know, all those things that make you go, oh my God, you know, make you go, oh my God, I want to like go back to Sasquatch Festival next year because, you know, I had this great time. I met, you know, these handful of artists that are just like, you know, kick-ass Seattle artists that are just, you know, busting it out, and you know, everybody we had was local from the area, and which was cool because those, you know, were a group of local Seattle artists doing a big installation performance piece at a festival, and you know, it became less about showing off about who we were and more about including the festival goers and making them feel like, you know, giving them a sense of empowerment and making them feel like they're artistic and can bring their artistic vision to the festivals. And the festivals I personally enjoy, and in my experience with being a festival attendee, is, you know, where everybody that goes to the festival is being creative in some kind of way.
Humanity at large, even I wasn't
expecting? Well, I was amazed at just how much garbage humans create. I mean, if you want to talk about that. Sasquatch was kind of interesting. And just like, you know, what humans are like when there's that many of them in one place.
It was really cool to have people approach me and be really inspired by what I was there doing and kind of just inspiring them to follow their dreams as well. It's definitely something that I experienced.
Like Brian was saying, it was like getting on top of a hill and then being able to see what the other side of the hill looked like and what was there. In fact, one of the magic moments really was when Ryan and I were standing and we could just see the entire gorge, and you know, there were no people there yet, and it really was this sort of landscape of promise. We'll be right back.
instant. I mean, with everyone, I felt like it was like something that I, at least personally, have been looking for a long time, having that community of different, all different artists collaborating in that kind of environment is something that I was super stoked about.
These were, I went to the store this morning.
Your song's called Volcano.
You went out into the world.
Went out into the world. It's still out there.
I don't believe it. I don't want to anymore.
Yeah, the experience so far has been great. It's been great being out here with my artist friends and just seeing all the reaction to everybody's thoughts on my work and all the people taking photographs with everything. It's been really, really fun. Half the people, I don't know if they got the work or not, but it's still fun to see how they react to it. And the people that do get it is a really special treat.
Happy birthday.
I had questions about why the some of the characters were missing limbs, and I explained to them that it was because of it was a symbolic of the lack of upward mobility in society now since the collapse of the economy. They don't have the limbs to climb the ladder any longer. And then they're like, oh, okay. It was freaking people out, but a little bit. And I was a little concerned about that, but I was like, you know what? If they have a problem with it, I'll explain it to them.
Very cool.
Oh, yeah. They're enjoying it and loving it. And most of the people here are great. It's fantastic, honestly. I think part of the reason why they wanted to bring visual arts and bring, you know, create a greater presence of visual arts here at Sasquatch is to do a little bit of a culture shift for the event. And I was doing that one person at a time last night. So.
Next year, but it'll be better.
Yeah, but I think just people being exposed to the art, you know, if they're not educated about art will help them to appreciate it more. Just being exposed to it.
Thank you. Yeah, I was doing a little mic check there. Let's see how we sound here.
Mic check.
Yeah, was not prepared for as many photographs that were going to be taken. That was rather new experience.
It's like you're there in this Sasquatch costume and you can't really see out of it that well. It's hot, it's about 80 degrees.
This is the second. There was two sets of costumes that we had.
Oh yeah, I gotta back up. Because there were the orange massive Sasquatch costumes. Those came out much later.
Yeah, the first round of costumes were pretty wet and sticky.
I think being able to execute my vision on a personal level as an artist was very fulfilling, and then also being part of a community of artists where I was able to get help and be of help to them executing their visions, and you know, watching us all work together, help each other out, and the community that we formed and the bond that we created as a group of artists was, I think, one of the, you know, coolest things I've ever experienced. And I think the confidence that gave me to, you know, keep stepping up my game, keep bringing more, you know, it's like, okay, I set a goal, I accomplished it, you know, what can I do in the future, you know, either at Sasquatch Festival or at other festivals. Or in other environments, different situations that are, you know, installation, performance-based stuff, you know I can accomplish this thing now.
Takeaway for you.
It's Ryan took that from me. You guys see his crack? Yeah. I had that first.
He learned that from me.
You get this on camera? This is important shit, man.
Yeah.
Tell that again, Murph.
I had that crack first.
Your finer quality.
It was my crack.
So basically, Ryan took your crack and ran with it.
Ryan's run to hit my crack. I mean, I tagged that shit first. And okay. Everybody knew it, too.
Okay. Now everyone will know it.
Now everyone will know it. Which is the right way.
Yeah.
Oh, you mean you guys are doing manual labor? I'm sorry. You guys have a good one.
Some bitch.
It wasn't that bad. It went pretty quick.
Yeah. A brief fantasy world.
Well, yes, it was.
Yes. An orgiastic dance party. A bacchanal. And then it fades into the desert again.
You know, Sasquatch Festival is one big giant party, and that's really what it is. It's like a, you know, multi-day party with, you know, tens of thousands of people, and there's a lot that goes into it, a lot of prep work, a lot of, I'd like to get a time lapse from a satellite and just watch, you know, like, you know, 2 weeks before this festival starts, you know, till when everything's disassembled, you know, that would be just a killer time lapse to watch, you know, this structure being built, all the people flowing in, all the, you know, this whole thing happening and then the disassemble. I think would be, you know, an interesting thing to have footage of from space.